Hey, what's up, guys? Spencer Rhodes here, and this is me analyzing the new cover of The Walking Dead comics. It is issue 177, part 3 of 6 of the New Order volume. And yeah, this cover definitely poses some questions. I've heard that there is a little bit of controversy regarding this cover, and I don't blame them. It's a little wacky. It's a little wacky. You know, first impressions, we haven't really seen these characters in the actual story yet, but you know, we've seen how, what, four or five of them look. We've seen the new female leader, the new president type of leader. I mean, we don't know for sure, but that's pretty much who we're thinking it is, just because of her desk and the way her desk looked. She really looked like a new Madam President in the zombie apocalypse. And then she had her bodyguards that had the white armor on. And then we got this guy, who kind of looks like Mr. T, and he has red armor. Also, does he look high? I don't know if it's just the what I'm looking at, but I'm looking at the cover and his eyes look pink. I don't know, like his eyes look a little pink. I mean, I don't know. No big deal. But yeah, he looks a little wacky. And the thing is, if this was the only wacky character that we've had, you know, for like 10 or 20 issues, it wouldn't be a big deal. But we just got a wacky character already. We just got introduced to a wacky character, and that wacky character was Jazz, the princess, what was her name? Yeah, the princess. And so, you know, we've got that wacky character, and then we've got this wacky character, and it's 5 or 6 issues within each other. So I think having two wacky characters introduced so closely together was kind of, I don't know, it just seems like a little bit much. The thing is, I want to reserve some judgment because we haven't actually read, you know, we haven't read these stories. We haven't really been introduced properly to these characters. We know about the girl from Ohio, but we don't know if she was even a part of the group, the army. We don't know. But we haven't actually seen the president and her bodyguards and these people. But this guy, who's apparently named Officer Mercer, he is not at the place where the president is. He looks like he's exploring. Maybe he's going out on a run, or he's searching for supplies or survivors. He's definitely from the group, because he has the same exact type of armor that the president's bodyguards had, but it's just red instead of white. So I don't know what he's doing, what he's up to. We still don't know if these people are good, bad, what their intentions are. All we can go by are the covers and the names, you know, Officer Mercer, New World Order, you know, and we know that the female leader is a presidential type of leader because of the way her desk looked. So I don't know. I don't know what to make of this. I'm guessing that these people, they're not bad and they're not good. And, you know, if I was to, you know, put them in one or the other, I'd say they're probably going to be good. But they could be dealing with people that are bad. They could be fighting another army of bad guys, or they could have bad guys on the inside, or people that are trying to take power, or people that are trying to double-cross the president. Anything is possible, but I know that a lot of people are upset about the way the characters look and the way this character looks, and to them I just say, let's just reserve a little bit of judgment. I mean, it's issue 175 at this point, and we're still reading. We're still here. So the comics have stayed at least a little good this long. Otherwise, we wouldn't be reading. We wouldn't be talking about this. You wouldn't be watching this video. I mean, you might not like the comics, but if you do like the comics, I would suggest just reserve a little bit of judgment. Just wait until we actually get the comics, get the first part, at least the first part of this volume, of the New World Order volume, and actually see how this plays out. You know, see the dialogue, see the story, see the dynamics, see what Robert Kirkman's plan is with these characters and with this new organization of people. It could be the best thing that's ever happened to the comics. It could be the worst thing that's ever happened to the comics. But I think it deserves a fair chance. That's what I think. I mean, you know, All Out War ended, and a lot of people were wondering, you know, what's going to happen after All Out War? You know, are the comics going to be good? And then we got the Whispers, and the Whispers were fantastic. You know, so I think any type of new character, any type of new group of people, I think we should give them a fair chance. I think we should give the storyline a fair chance and give Robert Kirkman a chance to tell the story. But I mean, this guy does look kind of wacky, so I totally understand the criticisms about this particular character, Officer Mercer, looking too wacky. I mean, his armor is red, and he's got two axes and a bunch of guns, and he's got those like those things on his arms or his yeah, closer to where his hands are. I mean, he's definitely armored up, and well, is it red or is it orange? Now that I kind of look at it, it kind of looks like it could be orange, like it could be orange armor. I feel like orange would be better than red. And some people are saying, you know, how the hell are we gonna get this in the TV show? And I don't think that's gonna be a problem. But you know, we've already seen these guys. We watched the Hunger Games. You know, the guys in the Hunger Games movies. Yeah, they could look like that. I mean, I could see it. One of the things I will say is it does seem like characters don't wear body armor enough. You know, when they go out on runs or go out scavenging for supplies, you know, Michonne, Eugene, Yukimo, Magna, Sadiq, they all went out to go to Ohio, and none of them have any armor. If one of them gets shot by a sniper, that's it. I mean, if they get attacked by, you know, 100 zombies, that's it. You know, armor kind of makes sense. So I can understand this guy wearing armor, and I can understand the president's bodyguards wearing armor. If I was in the zombie apocalypse, I would wear full body armor head to toe. I don't care if it slows me down, because that pretty much protects you from getting bit. It might not protect you from other things, like if you fight 100 walkers in armor, you could still possibly die. But it could protect you from getting bitten no matter what. You could get into a fist fight with 10 walkers with full body armor on and not get a single bite. It could be a way to kill big groups of them without using bullets. So armor is more practical, and I do think that it's kind of surprising that the characters in The Walking Dead, in Rick's group in Alexandria, they don't wear body armor more often. Like when Dwight and everyone went and fought the Whisperers and were killing all those zombies, did any of them have armor on? I guess they had some light armor. But I think you leave Alexandria, you leave the base, you should have full body armor, period. No exception, because you never know if someone really far away with a sniper rifle is going to try to shoot you in the face or shoot you in the chest. That way you at least have a chance of surviving. I just think it makes more sense, and I'm surprised that, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm surprised that characters have not worn armor more often, especially in the last 50 issues. I know there was that big part around the Governor story where Rick and Glenn had body armor, but that was about it. The characters don't have body armor that often. And I think it's kind of practical, and it kind of makes sense if you're going out on runs. So as far as the idea of this guy having body armor, I respect it, and him having a bunch of weapons, you know, that's fine. The color, I don't know. I mean, some people are criticizing the color, but think about it this way. What if there's 100 of these guys? You know, what if there's 100 people in this armor? Do you really want them to all be the same? Do you all want them to be the same generic color? What if there's different ranks? And if you're a really high rank, you're orange, or if you're a low rank, you're blue. If you're the middle, you're white. You know, there's all kinds of things that could be done with that. The problem is, since the comics are bl black and white, it kind of renders it mute, and it would be kind of hard to figure out, know who is what color, because they would really just be different shades of gray unless you look at the cover, and that way you know what color the character's armor is. But I think if it's just white and orange, that would be okay, because in the comics they would be grayish armor and then white armor pretty much, and that could work. That could totally work. So yeah, I think, you know, I want to give it a chance. I want to give it a fair chance. I want to reserve judgment. I think this could be really cool. I think it has the potential to be the best part so far of the comics. I really do. I think it could be the best part, the most exciting part. And I also think this could be a way to make Rick less important without killing him off. It could be a way to sort of relieve Rick of some of this leadership that he has had to carry. Because he doesn't have his support. He doesn't have Andrea anymore. Michonne likes to go off and do her own thing. You know, Rick was best friends with Michonne pretty much. But, you know, first of all, Michonne went to go get fish all the time. And then Michonne went on this trip to find the Ohio people. So Michonne, she and Rick are close. But she's not, you know, best buddies with Rick. Always having his back, always being around, always being like his own bodyguard or whatever. Michonne's not like that. Michonne's kind of going off and doing her own thing. She doesn't really like to stay in one place for too long. And Carl, he's pretty much wanting to do his own thing. You know, he wants to live at Hilltop. He's rebuilding Hilltop. You know, he's not even living with Rick. So Carl's kind of doing his own thing. Michonne's kind of doing her own thing. Andrea's dead. Rick and Dwight have kind of had a falling out a little bit. And then Jesus is pretty much Maggie's bodyguard. You know, Jesus cares about Maggie more than he cares about Rick. I mean, he might try to save Rick's life, but Jesus is primarily Maggie's right-hand man. Rick has always had a right-hand man. You know, it was Tyrese, then Abraham. Then it was kind of Jesus, but Jesus started spending more time with Maggie, and then he pretty much became Maggie's right-hand man. So what I'm getting at is that Rick really doesn't have much of a support system. And he's really still, I think he's pretty much broken from the loss of Andrea. And I don't think he wants to continue to be the big leader and make all the hard decisions. So having these people go to this organization, go to this, you know, these, it could be thousands of people, tens of thousands of people. And then Rick is maybe an advisor to this Madam President character, like the Secretary of Defense type of role for Rick Grimes. It would be a cool way to kind of keep him alive, keep him around, but not kill him off, but also give other characters like Magda more room to breathe. And we're going to talk about Magda because something was brought up on another channel that I wanted to talk about. But yeah, that's something that Dwight has talked to Rick about. That's something that they've already set up. They've already set up Rick having a smaller role, Rick no longer being the leader, and Rick taking a step back. Because Dwight has told Rick, you know, I don't think your decision-making is the best. I think you should step down and let me become the leader. And of course, Dwight was being a total dig, and he shouldn't have said all that stuff. He could have at least put it in a better way so that he didn't seem like such an angry asshole, because that's pretty much what Dwight has been lately. But I think they put that in there for a reason, hopefully not to kill Dwight off, because Dwight's awesome. But it could be to sort of set up that being true, that Rick might not be the super big leader that makes all the right choices, that makes all the hard decisions. He's not like that anymore. You know, he's weathered down, he's beaten up, Andrea's dead, all of his friends have kind of moved on and done their own thing. What more left is there for Rick to do? Are we just going to have another Whisperer War, another All-Out War? Because when you think about it, All-Out War and the Whisperer War were kind of similar to each other. It was a big battle between two armies, and you had a bunch of minor deaths, and then a couple of major deaths. And then it was over, and then Alexandria recovered. You know, I don't want that to happen a third time. I like the Whisperer War, but I don't want it to happen again so soon. I want something completely different. I want Robert Kirkman to find a new way to kill off characters, because you do have to kill off characters eventually. You know, every 5 or 10 issues, some characters gotta die. It doesn't have to be as often as it used to be early on, but you do have to continue to have conflict and have people killing each other and have the walkers be a threat and have characters die. Those are just kind of the ingredients in the comics. That's just a part of what the comics are. So having Rick serve as an advisor to the Madam President and have the Madam President deal with new kinds of bad guys or new kinds of conflicts, I think that would be a really cool direction to go, because it leaves plenty of room for other characters to grow, like Carl and Magna and Dwight and Michonne and Maggie. And maybe even Sophia. I mean, I feel like something big is happening with Sophia soon. Maybe not in the next couple of issues, but I feel like she's going to become a bigger character. But I think that would be kind of a cool way and kind of a good logical direction to have Rick no longer be the leader and just be an advisor to the president. And that way, you can continue to kill off characters and continue to do, you know, whatever. But I think this could be really cool, and I think this could re-energize the story, not saying that it's getting stale, but it could be a really refreshing, exciting direction for a comic series that's almost 200 issues in, that's been going on for almost 15 years. I think this could be totally cool. And the biggest thing for me, well, besides them not killing off Dwight, because Dwight's my man, but just kidding, the biggest thing for me is that I want this to be a logical portrayal or a logical progression of the zombie apocalypse. We're already 4 or 5 years into the zombie apocalypse. That's the thing that I'm really drawn to. That's the thing that's the most exciting, is that we're staying with the zombie apocalypse. We're continuing to develop the world, not just going through it and suffering through the zombie apocalypse, but recovering from the zombie apocalypse. We're seeing the world after the outbreak. We're seeing the future. We could go, you know, from 5 years into it to 6, 7 years. I want them to take their time and pace themselves, because I really want the story to explore the post-apocalyptic world, not just people killing each other and walkers killing everyone, but rebuilding. I really want to see that rebuilding process. I think that's the most fascinating aspect of the comics right now, is the rebuilding and seeing people's everyday lives when there is that 99% of the world dead. But everyone that's still alive, they've been alive for 5, 6, 7 years, that they've come back. The world has come back. The walkers are just a part of everyday life. It's not this big deal anymore. It's not this big devastating thing. I really want to see that. And I think this could be a really big opportunity to sort of showcase that. It's not about 50, 100 people at a time fighting each other and staying alive. It's about tens of thousands of people living everyday lives, and then there's a conflict, and then there's another conflict, and then there's a problem here and there. I don't want it to end with everyone dying. I think that's just kind of stupid and overly bleak and nihilistic. I just want to see the world continue to develop and continue to rebuild. And I think with this new world order, that's a really huge opportunity to do exactly that. Now, as I said, I was going to discuss Magna because I was watching Make a Path Presents, and Ronnie Hayes said something that was kind of interesting. He said that he's mad that the princess... Isn't her name Jasmine? But maybe I'm wrong, but the princess just got introduced and she's gotten more story than Magna, and Robert Kirkman said that Magna would be a big character, and she's been around for 50 issues and she's still not a big character. Yeah, I mean, I think it's still possible for Magna to become a bigger character, and I think this new world order could be a chance for her to shine. Because with the princess, yeah, she's gotten kind of a big introduction, but Father Gabriel got kind of a big introduction, and then he just spent 100 issues being in the background and not doing anything. So Jasmine could be like that. She could spend 100 issues being in the background and not doing anything. And then Magna could still get a chance to shine. I still think there's hope for Magna. I do think that it's possible with this new story, this could finally be Magna's chance to shine. This will finally be the part where Magna has something to do and she gains relevance. So, you know, my advice to comic readers is don't give up. I think the comics could possibly be getting better. Just give this a chance. Just give this the benefit of the doubt, because so far I have enjoyed the comics. I have continued to enjoy the story. They killed off Andrea, and I'm still enjoying the story. Last issue, 174, was one of the best issues in the entire series, in my opinion. So I think the comics could very well be in its prime, and it can continue to do so. I just think we should reserve judgment and not criticize it too much until we actually read the issues and see what the plan is with the story. Anyway, guys, those are my thoughts. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't be shy. Hit that like and subscribe. I'm not going anywhere. And I will see you guys later. Bye.